We are at JPL in the Mars Yard, and what we do here in the Mars Yard is we test robots driving around in different terrains just like we'd expect to see on the surface of Mars. So today we're driving Scarecrow out there. Scarecrow is a Mars weight vehicle for Curiosity. So Mars gravity is only 3/8 of Earth's gravity, and the Scarecrow rover weighs on Earth what Curiosity will weigh on Mars. We do that so that we can test how effectively the rover can drive up hills and over rocks. So you can imagine if you had a full weight rover here on Earth and you tried to drive up a hill, it wouldn't perform as well as it would perform on Mars because gravity is much less on Mars. So we have Scarecrow, which is just really the wheels and the suspension system. There's no robotic arm, there's no cameras, there's no science instruments to get it to weigh what Curiosity will weigh once it's on Mars. And then we drive around here in the Mars Yard over rocks, and we've got different slopes of 5 degrees, 10 degrees, 15 degrees, and we've got a sand pit where we drive up soft sand dunes at different slopes so we can characterize the behavior that we expect to see from the rover once it gets to the surface of Mars.
What we do in this room is we test components and subsystems that eventually get integrated into being a full-up spacecraft. A vacuum chamber is a chamber that we can pump all the air out of it, or almost all the air out of it. When you get to the point of seeing one molecule every 10 miles as opposed to seeing thousands of them per square centimeter. So you don't have an air environment in there to convect heat around. Imagine what it would be like if you had a fan blowing on you on a hot day, and then in a vacuum chamber the fan would spin but you wouldn't feel any air blowing on you. That's the type of thing that you're going to see in a vacuum chamber. So we'll pump it down to simulate space, or we can simulate the pressure that you would see on the surface of Mars. Some instruments are very sensitive to vibration, and what we have to do when they're doing critical functional tests is to shut down the air handling systems in here and test sometimes at night when we don't have truck traffic or anything else driving by. We build things as lightweight as we can because every ounce costs a fortune to get to another planet. So we're constantly trimming as much material off as we can, which makes our instruments very fragile. The challenge is to trim off everything that you don't need and still be able to survive the rigors of a launch and a landing.
This lab is known as the sandbox, and we call it that because of the sandy floor to simulate the Martian surface. And basically what we do is we do testing to kind of see how the rover will react in different situations. We'll test software before we upload it to the flight vehicle, and we'll go through rehearsals of what the actual rover is going to be doing when it's on the surface of Mars before we tell it to do those things. The model we have here is not an exact duplicate of the rover on its way to Mars. There are some differences. For example, gravity is different on Earth versus Mars, so we had to make things a little more robust so that it would survive, you know, driving it around day to day.
We are really flying three different spacecraft in one. So we have a crew stage that provides us power and telecommunications in the interplanetary flight. We have a descent stage that slows us down enough so we can have a soft landing on Mars. And we have a rover that weighs almost a metric ton, and we never send a payload so large and massive to the surface of the red planet. We have done all the testing necessary. We have simulated the whole entry, descent, and landing phase. But since we are on Earth, there's so much you can test with real hardware because we cannot really recreate the Mars gravity field. In reality, the first time that we're gonna be able to test the system as a whole is gonna be when we get to Mars, the night of August 5th. So that's one of the biggest challenges that we have. We have simulated everything, we have tested every single element, but the first time that we're gonna be testing the whole system as a whole is on landing day.